So now we've come to the point where we've been very successful on our numbers, have far exceeded the goals that the state has set in the original application. And so they have the governor and the general assembly has allocated additional funding that's implemented through the criminal justice coordinating council. And so there's two applications. The first one is continuation of continuation funding, which basically means you would receive the same $200,000 of your initial award. And the second, the enhancement funding application, in the amount of $105,700.52 would be to kind of enhance and add to that original $200,000. The way we came up with those numbers, that total of $305,777.52 would be enough to provide two full-time therapists for functional family therapy dedicated somewhat to Adams County. Over the past year, what we did is we partnered with Doherty County because we didn't have enough funds to have our own therapist on the team here in Adams County. So we partnered with them. And so we have one therapist serving us here in Adams, and two, the other two, they're part of the three-person team working with Doherty. This year, because we have the funding, we have our own team of two therapists here in Adams County. If we're awarded the full amount, based on some discussions I had with the CJCC and some of the other individuals involved in the process, they're very pleased with the results we've shown. And that's how I feel like we just got a good chance of getting awarded both applications. And we went with all the functional family therapy for a couple of reasons. Number one, I like the family aspect was more beneficial. It was kind of, we kind of got a bigger bang for our buck using the functional family therapy allowed us to reach better. Also, the additional placement training, we actually identified a way to without having to use grant funding. So we can still continue that service. That's still something that's available to the judge. We use some local providers, and they're right. To provide the service and bill either Medicare or paid insurance. So the judge can still refer people to that service. But it doesn't mean we'll have to come from, we'll have to allocate our grant funding away from the functional family therapy to provide it. So we've got a lot of that kind of allowed us to have the best of both worlds. We can still continue both programs with this amount of funding. This funding is enough for 64 additional. So, term what the goal of the program is, we're actually going to try it. And I think the goal is to not have them rip in. If they go for 3 years, and I think all that first 3 years is kind of the tipping point. And they feel like if they can go for 3 years without they don't rip in and they're not back in the system, they feel like it's been a success. Hopefully that's long term. That may be for this 12-year-old, then you have 3 years. If anybody's got track it, you say it's a 17-year-old. If they have it, they would consider it not successful, even if you're 19 and you're in trouble. That they would have done at that point, but they still track it that far out. Sessions.